Trusting in the promise of grace, let us pour out our hearts before God. Forgiving God, we repent of all the ways we turn from you, your call, but we do not listen. You show us your cross, but we prefer our own way. Forgive us, heal us, and lead us back to you, so that we might be a caring Christian community, where we share God's grace, grow our faith, and serve others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. In Jesus Christ, you are forgiven and given new life. Amen.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. Friends, let us pray. Draw your church together, O God, into one company of disciples, together following our teacher Jesus Christ into every walk of life, together serving in Christ's mission to the world, and together witnessing to your love wherever you will send us. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. When he was assigned to the temple, the Lord appeared to Jesus and said to him, "I am God Almighty, walk before me with grace, and I will make my covenant between you and Jesus, which will make you to be peace for the Lord." Then he returned to God on his face, and God said, "As for me, this is my covenant with you. You shall be a successor of all the nations. No longer shall you be a successor of
I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you. and go to the resources that God has given us. We were to be seen as a means to free them, and God would bless all of us. Old names were their old past, but these new names represented their life with God. What was born? Jesus is to fall and on our which is what happens in the house if you receive a new name. And each time we receive the Lord's Supper, every time words of forgiveness are proclaimed over us, whenever we receive the gift of God's grace, we are equipped for new vision. Our old self dies, and new life is born in the presence that includes all the world. Self-denial is death, self-self, and being made new. What we can accomplish on our own, and then what we can accomplish on our own. Jesus said, we will never fully get it. We are always disciples in the world. We enter Jesus' invitations to come to sell or carry crosses and fail to start. Never fully get it. Even so, God never gives it. Always invite us deeper into a deeper understanding of what it is that we need. And Jesus still entrusts the mystery to the truth and promises to bring us to the end. But of course, we are sent out into the trenches that come through the ages of the real life soldiers to just come with thousands of other prophets. We are sent out into our homes and our workplaces to examine the grocery store, to our neighborhoods and our schools. With our new name, the child of God, we fight against all the forces of evil that work against God's desires for us. We fight against injustice and hopelessness and despair. God's love and grace and forgiveness. In the midst of that work, God keeps redefining us. And our old self that we are called to be for God who seems small and so hard, less important, and the work we are called to be becomes important. And maybe even and here's the most important part. We do this work together. I love the part of the next year where it says, disciples and followers of Jesus join our communities defined by associations with Jesus. We are a community defined by our associations with Jesus. We may have wildly different views on lots of things. But we join this community based on our common deep desire to associate with Jesus. And so we are in communities together with ministry, together reflecting God's call, together falling and getting back up, together advocating for the vulnerable, together and slowly advancing the vision. The members of the Sea Public Web and Prince Trump stick together this year because they prove that. It was because of their bond with each other that they could focus on the vision as strange as it was. Thank you.